Final preparations for tomorrow's celebrations are in higher gears. Security has been beefed up at all entry and exit points to ensure that no wrong elements access the premises. All people are subjected to thorough checkups before being allowed to enter. Although social distance is impossible, the believers are encouraged to wear their face masks, which are distributed freely at the entrances. Since morning, Fort Porto de Asinsian choirs have been rehearsing for the celebrations. Father Joseph Musana, the choir leader, explains that there are over 300 choir members that will animate tomorrow's Holy Mass.
Basubire choir etendese bulungi. Choir efunye obudde ne bwekibanga babadde butono. Choir etegese bulungi egenda kuyimba. Genda kuba wenyimba, enyimba za Uganda zonna. Uganda yonna. Gamba guno mukolo sigwa Fort Porto de Asinsian yoka for to the hosts naye twagala kwaniriza abantu bona tuwa welcoming tubalage nyimba abaganda zibayimba.
Meanwhile, security chiefs led by the Inspector General of Police John Martin Tokoth Ochola inspected in and around the Catholic and Anglican sites this evening. Luke Owesijire, the Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson, explains that all is moving on smoothly except a few cases of theft reported.
We have a component of the police and UPDF, and it is already on ground. Lucky enough, we haven't registered any much incidents. We are only registering cases of theft ranging from clothes, money, and phones, which are also not above 20. And 12 suspects have so far been arrested at our police in Nachianja. I can only tell you that the place is well secured. Access control is available. Whoever is accessing the venue is being searched, and I believe tomorrow we shall have a very good Martyrs Day celebration here in Namugongo.
According to Prize Tayewa from the Red Cross Society of Uganda, emergency response teams are on alert to handle any forms of emergencies.
We are here in Namugongo to support other emergency service providers and health service providers to provide health services for the pilgrims. The pilgrims have come from far and near, so we are making sure that they are in good health. We start at the gate, whereby we are ensuring that SOPs are adhered to. We are giving masks. I hope if you came in, you might have received a free mask. We sanitize to make sure that we minimize infection. Then people who come with different conditions, swollen legs, different pains, muscle pain, joint pains.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.